I can't believe I'm finishing out the year with this rant, but it's on my mind because one of the biggest things I want to leave in the last decade, please, is Colin Kaepernick. You know who he is, the dude that made big waves and eventually big bucks by availing himself the opportunity to drop a knee right into the giant pile of horse crap, which is American racial politics. That's right, the Bob Ross-inspired dude bro with a dude fro who got famous not for being a good football player, but for having the bravery to rise from his millionaire status and his upper middle class white upbringing and rain down righteous verbal fire on the men and women of America's police forces by referring to them as racist pigs. Yes, this half black, half white, and all American imbecile that walks upon the surface of the troubled racial waters like Jesus himself, but instead of reaching out a hand to calm the storm, he's calling for more thunder and lightning. You're stirring it up, stirring it up. Now, fortunately, his execution of the calls has all the leak-proof integrity of a mob-run boxing match. And in the effort to rid the world of cruelty and unfairness, he's teamed up with, or perhaps chained himself to, Nike. That's right. One of the more legendary employers of fine sweatshop labor worldwide. And you gotta give Kaepernick some credit. Whatever sway it is that Nike thinks he has over the American public must be huge because they listen to him no matter what he says. It wasn't long ago Kaepernick called him up and told them that a line of shoes showing the Betsy Ross flag was racist, and guess what? Nike pulled the shoe. I lost my damn mind. Now, I wondered then and wonder now what flagrant sin he must have at some point walked in on at a Nike's headquarters to garner such power, especially when you consider that as of the moment, he's not even a football player, just some kind of weird astroturf lawn gnome. Now, we all watched with amusement a few weeks back when old Kaepernick pulled the ultimate arrogant move and didn't show up to the NFL workout he had scheduled and instead decided to hold his own workout elsewhere as if that's how it works. Hell, at this point, the NFL would rather sign Uncle Rico and listen to him talk on and on about throwing a football over a mountain when he was in high school than deal with this spoiled brat. And yet, here's Nike, still somehow finding a way to capitalize on this albatross hanging about the NFL's neck. I love the fact that the wide receiver that tried out with him actually got signed to a contract. A couple of weeks ago, though, back to this point, Nike launched a line of Kaepernick-inspired shoes which sold out in minutes online. Minutes! Now, what in the world's going on around here? For a little over $100, which is about what Kaepernick's football career is worth these days, you can be the proud owner of a pair of Nike-endorsed reminders that you should all hate police for the crimes, and in some case, supposed crimes, of just a few. Now, who's buying these damn things? I think it's Kaepernick. I think he's buying his own shoe. I think he's got a closet at home full of shoes and hairspray cans and some Soul Glow. And from the very beginning, this whole thing has seemed like a ploy on Kaepernick's part to first become and then stay relevant. But the unfortunate side effect is that he stands for something that is both disgusting and dangerous to the tattered fabric of our society. Blah! Now, obviously, Black Lives Matter, Kaepernick. They do. Of course they do. And when you go on and on talking about it the way you do and then sell yourself out to some of the last people who should be talking about public injustice, you're a little hard to take seriously. One more thing. I saw a picture of Kaepernick recently. It was on Facebook, so it must be real. It shows him flashing the, wait for it, you know, the okay hand sign in the camera. Shock and awe, folks. My determination is that Colin's white half is trying to oppress his black half, and thank God he's got that chia pet on his head to protect the side that's supposed to win. Now, don't be like Colin Kaepernick, folks. Go out there, live 2020, live your lives, let others live their lives, and let everybody else be happy and proud and stand for justice when you can. Just make sure your stand isn't a super obvious bid for fame and fortune. I love y'all. God bless. Willie, tell them Happy New Year. Willie, tell them Happy New Year. You back there taking a knee. Here's a Facebook poke. Happy New Year.